also the fact that these areas right now are very poor, and they've got a large young population. In other words, there's a very large majority of the population in a lot of these places that's below 30 years old. A lot of them are peasants who have been coming into cities, and that always creates a lot of friction and a lot of potential for mischief.
Yeah, there's population explosion pressures, and what you're saying is, you misunderstood, is exactly what I'm saying. They're taking the culture, warping it, creating a, well, it's the same thing with Pol Pot that Brzezinski brags about, how, yeah, I used Pol Pot, I picked him, we built him up, he killed 30% of the population, that stopped the communist. But then at another level, they were also funding the communists. So anything to destabilize, would you agree then they use that same culture type manipulation with the Khmer Rouge, saying we're going back to the rural society, just like they say your Muslim culture is a Bedouin society, kill the Westerner, then they use them as a menacing pawn to set up their police states domestically and have a pretext to invade the Middle East?
Yeah, certainly. And Al-Qaeda, if you look at what they preach, it's the idea that there has to be a caliphate, meaning that all the existing governments are illegitimate. So that means that if you want to overthrow any of these governments, from Saudi Arabia to Egypt or whoever it is, according to bin Laden, really a troop of actors, all of those places are illegitimate. And at the same time, you've got to be backward. And at the same time, you can't make alliances with anybody else. You can't ally with Japan or Russia or China or Brazil or South Africa. You're not allowed to do any of that because
key, make them rigid so that they're now isolated.
Yeah, in effect. So let's look now at the way in which this might be applied. And here it takes some scenario spinning. But in order to get something going at the level that they would like for the needs of now, and now is not then. Now is not how do you bomb Iran. That's useless. You can do that anytime you want. But it's got to be now, and I think this is why this coup attempt in Iran is so interesting. Here we have the Green Revolution. We have Mousavi, who was the prime minister during the Iran-Iraq War. The Iran-Iraq War is a good example of, frankly, of Brzezinski's methods, and it started under Brzezinski, for God's sake, or very soon after he left office. So you encourage Iraq to attack Iran, part of that being to tie them both up, to destroy them both. You're also interested in consolidating Khomeini in Iran when he's showing signs of collapsing. And the prime minister who presided over that 8 years of war is Mousavi. And among the other things, this was the time when the mullahs would go around and get young kids to go to the front and become martyrs' brigades. They would rush at the prepared positions of the Iraqis with machine guns and minefields and barbed wire, and they would just get mowed down. There was, of course, this famous fountain of blood in Tehran to memorialize these martyrs. That's Mousavi. Now, that's the Anglo-American candidate of today.
So he's perfect because he kills Persians. It's another eugenical.
Well, he's been retooled. I mean, what he talks about now is internet freedom. That there's got to be internet freedom and more privatization. So he wants the full IMF shock therapy.
Yeah, foreign banks coming in, inoculations for everybody. Webster, I want to finish up with Iran, but the time we've got with you, I want to look back domestically because we're now seeing the Obama squads try to get people kicked off the radio. We're now seeing them go after sponsors. We're now seeing them say it's illegal to criticize them. Any criticism of healthcare takeover, anything is racism. I want to get your take on the healthcare takeover, the carbon tax. I want to run through a few bullet points with you and some other stories, but go ahead.
Well, let me just say, one of the things that has got this going is this birth certificate issue. And I would simply say this. There's such a thing as the long-form vault copy birth certificate, the original. And original means 1961 original, means with things typed in.
Yeah, not a receipt. Not a receipt.
Not a receipt. Not something that.
But I mean, you heard Matthews. I asked you during the break. What do you think of him panicking?
Well, I think that there is a hysteria in the Obama Kool-Aid cultists, and it was in the world of these lemmings, the Chris Matthews and others. There is a genuine hysteria about this, and it encapsulates, along with some other incidents that have happened lately, is their class hatred. In other words, it's an elitist hatred by these foundation-funded intellectuals and media types against what amounts to the U.S. population, in particular blue-collar workers and anybody who's involved in anything productive, they think is their class enemy, and that's the hysteria that they
yeah, they're afraid of independent farmers, auto workers, black, white, they don't care. If you're a real man with a real family and Normal, they don't like it because they're the parasite economy that openly is waging. I mean, I was looking at the global warming funding and it's all Goldman Sachs, all JP Morgan. Like you said, and it's in the new film coming up, they literally are waging war against reality.
And the obvious tendency of a regime like Obama is to collapse into a kind of Carter catastrophic abortive interlude. In other words, a one-term presidency with very high unpopularity that then gets booted out, and then, of course, leads to a period of ultra-reaction. When you look at the Republican Party, say, under somebody like Mitt Romney, the asset stripper and hedge fund hyena, I think that's where the Republican Party
is going.
So
we'll go out of a fake left wing into a kind of false libertarian corporate looting.
Yes. With, again, Mitt Romney, I think, is the face of what is likely to prevail inside the current Republican Party. When it comes to these policies, cap and trade, it's very easy. Cap and trade is simply no, and stop this completely. When you get to health care, you've obviously got Obama having really identified or revealed a genocidal mentality in the sense he talks about his mother's hip operation, that she had been ill with cancer but had a hip operation. And Obama says that this was an ethical dilemma for him, whether his sick mother should get a hip operation. This is the guy who shovels trillions of dollars, $24 trillion so far, across the room for AIG and Goldman Sachs and J.P. Morgan and Citibank and the rest of these bandits. Obama, he sounds more and more like the president of the Hemlock Society. He talks about hospices, how much he likes hospices. These are places where you go and they give you a drug cocktail, and that's pretty much the end of you.
Well, that's what I was going to say, Webster. They keep saying this isn't government-controlled, but then a lot of doctors are saying it is eugenics. They're now saying we're going to have an ID card that has what we eat, what we do on it. No, I'm not kidding. This is LA Times proposing it. And that the bureaucrats will decide if you've lived your life right and if you get health care. And then they admit this is to lower the carbon footprint. I have mainstream articles saying it's good for old people to die. And Daschle, I have his book.
Right, Daschle.
He says if you're above 60, no eye surgery. And then I have video of Tony Blair when he was asked in the Commons, hey, you got to wait 18 months for a brain surgery that's inoperable after 6 months, but is 90% operable if you do it in the first two. And he said, yeah, you don't need to have that. You need to die. It's not some Republican propaganda to say this is eugenics. This is really happening.
It clearly is. Now, here's the problem, though. You do have 50 million people who have no insurance, and you have about 18,000 who die a year because they don't get health care. But just in terms of Obama, as long as you've got Orsag up there, the director of the OMB, Orsag is the guy who tells you that you should not have an MRI, you should not have a CAT scan, you should not have a nuclear stress test, you shouldn't have a PSA or whatever it is. This obviously also a genocidal sort of bean-counting, pointy-headed bureaucrat mentality. And then the other one is Holdren, and this is really, I think,
I meant to get you on about
example.
Originally. Webster, stop. Exactly. In fact, when the crews come and interview you again, final interview for the film, I've done 17 now with other people, Holdren comes out with a textbook about forced abortion, forced sterilization, putting
exactly.
stuff in the water, CPS to take all kids, to raise them in government, hive buildings. I mean, it actually everything in one document we already knew. Tell me about that.
Well, I've got his book, Eco-Science, and this is it's co-authored with Paul Ehrlich. Paul Ehrlich was the professor at Stanford University, an absolute crackpot and charlatan, whose most famous book is The Population Bomb. And he was talking about a worldwide population explosion, and now here we are 35, 40 years later. There has been no such thing. As a matter of fact, the population in many parts of the world is falling. Certainly in European Union, it's falling. In Japan, it's falling. In the U.S., it would be falling if it weren't for immigration. So this is Holdren. He's basically a partner of the discredited crackpot, Paul Ehrlich. And indeed, this is what they write about. Coercive, involuntary measures to prevent population growth, to get into the area of compulsory sterilization, limits on families, special taxes. In other words,